like how it tried to get me from behind. Alright.
Thank you. Team infiltration confirmed. Use appropriate caution.
Everything's set. And here we go.
It's a fox. Cutie. Oh my god, yes. Okay. Okay.
This place doesn't feel like depths as much as it does a hideout.
It certainly is ideal terrain for staying out of sight.
Could the Crimson Queen be holed up here? Well, Hilda? Is there a chance? That's just perfect. The radio's on the fritz.
This is really thick.
You gonna be okay? Doesn't this mess with normal God-eaters like you?
Yes. However, even accounting for bias factor specialized for the Ashlands, we can't linger for any longer than is strictly necessary.
Well then, we'll stay as long as we can.
Huh? Wait.
What? Are they Aegis?
The Crimson Queen.
Long time no see, bro.
Oh no.
Is that you? Neil?
What are you doing with the Crimson Queen?
Neil? Is this the little brother you were telling us about? The one that went missing?
Just listen for a bit, okay?
If you've made it this far, then that means your mission is nearing its completion. Success is not far off. Congratulations. So, you're Werner? In the flesh. I am Werner Gavlin. I'm the founder and leader of the Crimson Queen.
And what business does the Crimson Queen have with us? If you plan on hurting my comrades...
I don't want any violence. I'm here to talk. Hear me out for a moment.
Go on.
What we've built here is a nation of Aegis. It is a place where we can live as human beings, free from the burdens of class and discrimination. Here, we have left the rot of the outside world behind, and we are building a land of principles.
And going around setting off ash storms? Exactly what sort of principles are those?
It is true, though regrettable, that some of our members could not overcome their desire for revenge against their former owners. You should understand. You should all understand. And who can blame them after being treated in the despicable way that Aegis are? You may hold me responsible for their actions, though I failed to stop them. I do not support what they did. Vengeance only breeds more vengeance. However, now we have finally struggled free from the chains of hatred. Now that we have a safe haven, there's no reason for conflict.
How is it that you can live out in the ash like that? Even Aegis can't stick it out long enough to live in it when the levels start getting this thick. It's because we have bias factor made from the humanoid origami cells. Thanks to its properties, we have near total resistance to the ash. From that bastard Inukai?
Yes. We did become concerned when this cover with Gleipnir was compromised, and we lost access to the supply. But now, we have what we need.
Her.
We do not forgive those who have persecuted and continue to persecute Aegis, but neither do we seek their destruction. We simply wish to create a paradise for ourselves, one where we can make our homes and live out our lives in peace. A place where people can be born, live their lives, have their own children, and pass away. That is the underlying purpose we seek as part of the Crimson Queen. We know what you've you've been doing. You are ages, but you've managed to grow so strong that even Gleipnir cannot ignore you. I ask you, will you not lend us that strength?
Hugo, this place they're describing, what they're saying is... I have to admit, it does sound like a lofty goal.
Come, be a part of it.
No.
Sorry, but I'm afraid you'll have to ask someone else. We have a job to do.
And you? I'd be curious to hear your thoughts. Do you agree with him? Very well. Then we will wait until you can give us your answer. Fenrir HQ is further ahead. You shouldn't have much trouble reaching it. But beware of the Infernal Lord who sleeps there. I pray for your victory.
The brother looks like a character I would like to. He's very Final Fantasy-esque. That's funny. She has that look where she's like,
just about anything. I can't wait to give this a try.
She's never said that before.
Racking up the kills!
That's what I was thinking. He wants Beam because he already said using her cells, they were able to live. Because she's close with me and won't part with me, I kind of have a feeling that, in order to get her, he needs me also. Oh, rain.
Ash levels will not hinder the mission. Take care, everyone.
Here we go.
Zeke, make contact with secondary target and is in pursuit. Affirmative.
Missed it. Literally, it's in front of me.
Thank you.
So I gave my life to save them. I can't pull out my shield with the gun out, is what it is. But they won't give me time to change it. What happened is I couldn't change my form, and you can't guard with the gun out, so I just kept taking all the hits repetitively because I couldn't switch out. And every time I tried, I would get hit again, so. That's why I don't like using it. I only use it sometimes. Well, I try to use it towards the end every time to make it effective, but. God, that was ridiculous. This is why I hate doing optional ones, because I want to focus more on the story shit, and I can't because they have more dumb optional shit for me to do. Jesus Christ. Camera.
anything coming?
No, nothing. Hold on. What's that? What? Just one attack?
Wait, what's going on here?
That aura isn't normal at all. Have we met before?
I'm getting the feeling this isn't the time for a teeny chat.
What do we do, Hugo? We haven't seen anything like this before. We have to take this chance. You good? I can see it. Our future lies just ahead. We will get there. You and me. Everyone. Together.
Are you sure? I was trying to throw shit on the ground to heal them and it killed me. Serious. Oh, come on.
Hound one. Burst status running out.
Flow is running alive. Oh, oh, oh. Right in the face. King of the Underworld.
So, that's Fenrir HQ.
I have confirmation. Writ to Fenrir HQ established. The underground factory should be intact. The mission is a success.
We really made it.
Operation successful.
It's finally over.
Or is it?
Okay. Now. Let's catch our breath.
Congratulations, ma'am. It looks like we'll all be busy after this.
Indeed. Thank you, Ricardo. You've done a wonderful job here, everyone. We've done it. We've finally opened a route to Fenrir HQ. Let's have you all come back home for now.
Right. Hilda, just give us a few minutes to rest first.
We're all completely worn out after taking this one down.
Don't blame me if you get bitten by Ash Aragami.
Not gonna happen. We'll eat them all first.
We're getting congratulatory messages from all the caravans! There are so many of them!
They underestimated us, but they finally realized we're not just some pack of idiots.
Yeah, you're right. We finally won back our freedom. This is where it begins. The dawn of our new day. Do you think that everybody else will be happy for us too?
Maybe, maybe not.
I guess we'll all be parting ways soon, won't we?
Are you heading back?
Yes, my next mission still awaits. But I'll still come to visit sometimes.
Yeah, we'll be waiting for you.
Good.
Let's start moving. The kids are waiting for us back at the port. We're on our way home, guys.
And so, the Fenrir HQ Reclamation Initiative ended in success.
Oh my god, is that Yuri Lando?
That night, they all celebrated the victory they had won for themselves. The festivities went on until the bright morning dawn. Gleipnir turned Fenrir HQ into a new base and loudly proclaimed the rebirth of humanity. Hilda Enriquez laid claim to the vast reward her efforts had earned and set off homeward to her port. The caravan ages used their own share of the rewards as capital to start down a new path for themselves. Spirits were high. It was the first time they had both the right and the means to live their lives as they pleased. And so, a month passed by.
That's straight up Yuri Lowenthal. Historian. God, it's like weird, almost Christmas music. Different ground, European.